So we're going to have a look at this school database task, and we'll break it down into little bits so you can see how each part works. Okay, I'm just going to explain how each part works, because at the moment it looks quite long and complex, but actually if we break it down it's pretty straightforward. So the first part of the system is the login part. So up here we've specified three variables: real you, and that's the username, which we've called Lehman, real underscore p, which is the password, which is 1234, and logged in, which is equal to false. Okay, and what that's going to do, that's going to control when we need to log out the system, in other words, when we want the program to end. So we've set up a while loop, and we said while logged in is equal to false. Okay, now it is equal to false at the moment because we've set it to false, and it will remain false until we change it. Okay, so while logged in is equal to false, print please log in and enter your username. So we've got an input here where we enter our username. So if we run this in parallel, you'll be able to see what happens here. Here we go. Now the username, let's say if we enter something incorrectly and press enter, it will say user not found. Okay. The reason it's doing that is because it's not getting past this bit here. So if real username, which is Lehman, is equal to you, which is the input, so we put in Bob, so those two are not equal, so therefore it's not doing any of these nested if statements. What it's doing is, if we scroll down, we've got an else saying user not found, and then it's asking us again for the username, and that's because we've set up this loop here. Okay, because logged in is still equal to false. Okay, so that will keep asking us. So if we enter in the correct username this time, which is Lehman, it's now done this. So real you is equal to you. Okay, so it's now got to the next bit here, enter your password. Now if I enter the wrong password, this bit won't happen. So again, it will go around to user not found and it will loop around again. Okay, so I will enter the correct password this time, which as we can see is 1234. All right, there we go. So now this loop has now finished, okay? So logged in is now equal to true, okay? So this part of the program here is done, all right, because we've entered the correct username and password. So we move on to the next bit, and now that's another loop. While logged in is equal to true, okay? So now logged in is true, all of this will happen, okay? And what we've got here is we've got a choice equals input, okay, and that is this bit here. So our menus come up as a series of print statements, and now we've got to choose a number, and these numbers correspond to the if statements down here and the elif statements. Okay, so if we choose one, what will happen is I've set up a function, okay, called enter details, and if I choose one, that will run. Now enter details is up here, it's at the very top, so this will run if I pick number one, and we'll talk about that a bit more shortly. And then we've got various other functions which control different parts of the program. Okay, but down here we've got logged out, so we could choose six, okay, which will log us out of the system. And what that will do is, if we do choose six, that will switch logged into false. Okay, and what that will mean is this loop will now stop running. Okay, because this loop will only run when logged in is equal to true. But because we press 6, it will change it to false, and therefore it will throw us out the program. You are not logged in. So let's just see that happening. So if I press 6, there we go. And it sent us back to this bit up here, okay, the original login. Okay, so I'm just going to log in quickly. And I'm just going to choose number one so you can see how the first function works. So if I choose number one, it will give me this print statement, you've chosen to enter student details, and it will run this function up here, enter details. So in other words, what we'll see is this bit. Okay, so the first thing it will say is please enter some student details. So if I just do that to show you how that works, there we go. So that's now running this part of the program, and I'll explain how this works in the next video.